Yes, good morning dear students, welcome to the physics class. Today we are going to discuss about the wave number. Okay, so what do you mean by wave number? As you can look on the board, it is the number of waves per unit length. Okay, number of waves per unit length. For example, we have two waves. One wave means it is containing one crust and one trough. It's called one wave. Two wave means two crust and two trough is two wave. Okay. Suppose let me consider two waves. It's one wave, right? So from here to here it is one wave, and from here to here it is second wave. Okay. Here many waves are totally two waves. The length of two waves is equal to 10 meter. Then what will be the number of waves in a unit length? Means two waves in 10 meter, how many waves you can find in a 1 meter, means unit length? That is 2 divided by 10, which is equal to 0.2. 0.2 waves we are going to have in a 1 meter of length, or else in a unit length. That will be called as the wave number. And then here, I just consider one wave. It is one wave, okay? And what is the length of this one wave? So from here to here, it is one complete wave. And length of that wave will call it as a wave length lambda. Okay? So in a lambda, how many waves we are having? One wave we are having. Okay? So, here for one wave, lambda is the length of the wave. Then what will be the number of waves per unit length? That is represented by the word nu bar. Nu bar is nothing but a wave number. So here, wave number nu bar is equal to 1 by lambda. Means the one wave multiplied by the that wave. A similar wave to previous, we have measured two waves in a 10 meter. So 2 by 10 is equal to number of waves in a unit length. So here is one wave, the length is lambda meter. So 1 by lambda is going to give the number of waves in a unit length. Is it clear? Okay. Next, we are having expression for wave number. Right? So nu bar, it is the indication of wave number. As we know, the energy of the young Bohr atom, nth Bohr orbit in a hydrogen atom. The energy of nth Bohr orbit in a hydrogen atom, or the energy of an electron in the nth orbit, is given by n is equal to minus m e to the 4 whole divided by a epsilon space, n space, h space. So let us take that equation number 1. So here m is the mass of the electron, that is 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg, and E means it is the charge of electron, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, and H means the Planck constant, that is 6.62 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second. Okay. And the permittivity of the free space, that is 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad per meter. And that is the number of orbit. Now, the next step, let us consider E means the energy in the L orbit. So, similarly, we will consider E and 1 and E and 2 be the energy of a level m1 and m2, or energy lower energy state. EM1 means lower energy state, and EM2 means the higher energy state. Respectively, energy of EM1 and EM2 means energy of lower state energy of the lower state. Now if an electron is going to jump from N2 to N1, an electron is going to jump from N2 to N1, that means from the higher energy to lower energy, here I have it, from N2 to N1, right? What is going to do? It is going to emit the photon. It is going to emit a photon. So here, the energy of that photon will be given by from the force of third postulate. Here is equal to En2 minus En1. That is the difference in the energies of the orbits, two orbits. Okay. So now we know nu. Nu means it is the frequency of the radiation which has been emitted during the transition of electron from the higher orbit to the lower orbit. So here nu is equal to c by lambda. It is the frequency c by lambda. So that is process n into nu. Instead of nu, we just have to substitute c by lambda, which is equal to En2 minus En1. Now, go to the equation number 1. Equation number 1 is going to give the energy of n orbit. Using this one, we need to write the energy of g orbit N2 and the energy of the orbit N1. That is simple. Wherever we find n, you just have to substitute N2 and N1. Okay? So that is for En2 minus 1 is equation 4 times the A epsilon square, N2 square, and H square. And minus of this minus, 1 more minus than that. That is plus 1 equation 4 A epsilon square, N1 square into H square. So now we have 1 equation 4 A epsilon square, H square. I'm going to take this as a common. So after getting it, young integration 4 times by A epsilon square and H square common, what we are going to get inside the bracket? That is 1 divided by N1 square, and it is minus 1 divided by N2 square. So here, let's see, we are having an electric effect. Bring them to access. In the electric, there is a numerator. When you bring them to access, there will be moving for the lower side, means the denominator. So that is 1 by lambda is equal to young into c to the power 4 as it is divided by a epsilon square. That is square, and then when it is next to the square, that is 1 h. So it becomes h cube into c. This is divided 1 divided by n1 square minus 1 divided by n2 square. 1 divided by n2 square minus 1 divided by n2 square. Just call it as equation number 2. Okay? So here, this quantity, 1 equals 4 divided by h epsilon square h cube c, it is the nothing but the integral constant r. It will be taken as r equal to the integral constant, whose value is 1.097 into 10 to the power 7. Per meter. It's clear. Okay. Now, the equation number 2. Instead of writing this form here, I just write it R. Okay. R is visible constant. And we know that 1 by lambda is what? That is the base number. 1 by lambda is the base number, mu bar. So instead of 1 by lambda, writing the mu bar, it is equal to R into 1 by lambda squared minus 1 by lambda squared. Okay. This is what? The reciprocal of the wave 1 by lambda is 0.7. It gives the reciprocal of wave. If you want to get the wave, then what you need to take? The reciprocal of 6.8 will give you the wavelength. Okay? Which is what? The reciprocal of wavelength. R into 1 by lambda square minus 1 by lambda square. If you get the reciprocal of wavelength, if you want to get wavelength, then you need to take. So here I am taking you as a frequency of the radiation which has been emitted during the transition of electron. Okay, so already we know it will be equal to E by lambda. Here we have one. Okay, so I will write this as Yama. So what do you mean by Lamba Yama? That is the Yama, Yama number. So frequency is equal to C into K number. So now, if you want to calculate the frequency of the radiation which I am doing in there, you just have to do wave number in our, okay? So just you have to manufacture wave number by with C. With C, then C has to be wave number in the R is 1 by N squared minus 1 by N squared. It is what? The frequency of radiation which has been, or a frequency of the photon which has been emitted during the transition of electron from higher level N2 to the lower level N1. Okay. So here the next concept is atomic spectrum. Atomic spectrum. Actually it acts as a fingerprint of an atom. The spectrum, atomic spectrum acts as a fingerprint of a atom. Okay. So what do you mean by spectrum then? Spectra or a spectrum means, so here the group of colors. So here if an electron is jumping from higher orbit to lower orbit, for example, consider an electron is going to jump from higher orbit to lower orbit, it is going to emit a radiation or else a photon. So that radiation of different wavelengths together, we will call it as spectrum. Is it clear? So here there are two types of spectrum. One is light emission spectrum. Another one is light absorption spectrum. Okay. One is light emission spectrum. Another one is light absorption spectrum. So first here I write the light emission spectrum. Means atoms whichever in that hydrogen gas will get the extra energy, or when you heat the hydrogen gas it will be excited. So what happens? An electron in the hydrogen atom is going to jump from the lower orbit to higher energy orbit. Okay, but it will be there in the higher energy level for a very short interval of time. After that, again it wants to go to its ground level or lower energy level. Now, in order to move from higher energy to lower energy, what it has to do? It has to emit the photon, it has to emit the radiation. Right? So here, the emitted radiation will be of a different wavelength, and these wavelengths will give the spectrum. That spectrum is called as light emission spectrum. Is it clear? So whenever an electron from higher level in the hydrogen gas, excited hydrogen gas, whenever electron is going to move from higher level to the lower level, it is going to emit the radiations of different wavelengths, and these different wavelengths were going to give the spectrum of radiation, and that is called as light emission spectrum. And next one is light absorption spectrum. Okay, so whenever a white light is passed through a hydrogen gas, whenever a white light is passed through hydrogen gas, then in the spectrum we are going to get the dark patches of the dark lines, and those lines are called as light absorption spectrum. Okay, that lines are called as light absorption spectrum. And now I'll just go some a little bit of detail about the light absorption spectrum. So how to get this line absorption spectrum? So here, first you have to plot on the graph that the different wavelengths present in the white light. Okay, white light. In white light, we are going to get the common color. That is the visible geo. Okay, sorry, not the white. Visible. So that is violet, yellow, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. Right? So we are having the different wavelengths. So first, we need to plot a graph for these different wavelengths. Okay? So just we need to consider a graph sheet, and on that graph sheet, we have to mark the wavelength for different color light. Means these are the colors which are being included in the white light. Okay? So then next, so we are having the white light which is having 7 different wavelengths or 7 different colors of different wavelengths, and that we have noted on a graph sheet. So here is the graph sheet, here is the white light, and in front of white light we have a graph sheet, and on that graph sheet we have noted the place of the different wavelengths which are present in the white light. That graph is going to indicate the perfect place of the wavelength or perfect place of the different colors which are being present in the white light. Now, in front of this white light, we need to place a hydrogen gas. Here, white light, hydrogen gas, here, the graph, and that will be considered as a screen. Okay. So now, when we place the hydrogen gas in front of the white light, dark lines were going to appear on the graph sheets in the place of particular wavelength, in the place of particular color. Okay? So why that is so? So here, the hydrogen is going to absorb some of the particular wavelength from the white light. Okay, so in the place of those colors, in the place of those wavelengths, we are going to find the dark lines. Okay, so here the hydrogen atom is, or hydrogen gas is going to absorb the particular wavelength which can be emitted by the hydrogen. Okay, so here hydrogen is going to absorb a color, only such colors which can be given out by, which can be emitted by the hydrogen gas. Is it clear? Okay. So next here, as you can see, so here are the graphics. So these are the marks which are the different scientists. Is it clear? Okay. It's about light absorption spectrum. Okay.
So next we are having the different temperature formulas. Different temperature formulas given by the different scientists. One of them is Lyman. So first one is the Lyman theory. It is the theory obtained due to transition of electron from any higher orbit to the first orbit. If electron is jumping from any higher orbit to the first orbit, so here it is a nuclear and it's the first orbit, second orbit, third orbit, fourth orbit, sixth orbit, like that we are having the infinite number of orbits. Okay. If an electron is going to jump from nuclear, from second to the first orbit, or from third to the first orbit, or from fourth to the first orbit, or from sixth to the first orbit, or from any of the higher orbit to the first orbit, then whatever the series we are going to get, that will be called as a Lyman series. Okay, that will be called as a Lyman series. So here, due to transition of an electron from the higher orbit to the first orbit. Right? So here, we have the formula that 1 by lambda is equal to R into 1 divided by n1 minus 1 divided by n2 square. Right? It is the formula divided by the variable, right? Or the reciprocal of the variable. So here, if an electron is going to jump from any infinite orbit to the first orbit, it has to be certain variations, right? And whenever it jumps from fifth to first, it will have a different variation. And whenever it jumps from fourth to first, third to first, second to first, and so during these many transitions, it is going to emit the different wavelength. Okay? And that wavelength is going to be calculated using this formula, 1 by lambda equal to R is 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. So here n1 means what? It is the lowest energy state. Okay? And n2 means what? It is the higher energy state. What is the lower energy state in the Lyman series? Means electrons can be transferred from higher state to the first orbit. Higher state to the first orbit. That means n1 means 1. Okay? So, 1 by 1 by 1 by 1 by 1 by 1 square minus 1 by 1 square. Why? Because it's the lower state. All electrons are going to jump to the first level. So, that's why n1 is equal to 1. And what is the value of n2 here? N2 means it is more than 1. That means, how many which are less than 1? That is 2 or 3. For any orbits, okay? So this is called as Lyman series. And the second one is the Balmer series. It is the series obtained due to transition of electrons from any higher orbit to the second orbit. Any higher orbit, if they come from infinity, so it will be taken as not a fixed one, it will be taken as infinite one, okay? If the electron is taken from infinity to the second orbit, it will be the second orbit here. Okay. An electron is going to jump from infinity to the second or fifth to second. Just a little bit. From infinity to second, or from fifth to second, or from fourth to second, or from third to second. Right? So, series obtained, the series means the different radiations of the different wavelengths obtained in the transition of different
Alright? Vamasiri. So here, 1/9 into r into 1/5. General, what is general then here? The lowest position is 2 here. Okay? This is square minus 1/n² So here, n² means more than 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. Okay? So next, third one, passion series. Passion series.
Okay, and the line of the series is that for the ultraviolet.
creation of the universe, the reason for the development of things, and the passion infrared religion.